All right, everybody, Hafaday, and welcome back to the show. As you may know, and certainly if you watch KUEM, you certainly should, there is a Toys for Tots drive going on right now, and it's for a very, very good cause. It's to help the island community and let us be all one big family around the holidays. So we want you to get involved, and here to tell us about it are Kayla Blend and Shannon Atta. They are from Guam High School. Ladies, Hafaday.
Hi.
All right, and even though it is Thanksgiving week, we'll go in and say, you know, like a happy holidays.
Yes, thank you. Happy holidays.
A tad early. But certainly the holiday spirit is with you and your classmates and everything, getting involved with this with our friends at the U.S. Marine Corps. So tell us, what has your involvement been and how has it been so far?
Well, at our school, we've actually involved the Toys for Tots activity to blend with our students and also to the activities we hold at school. And what we did is we made a competition with our pep rallies.
Yes, so at Guam High we have something called the Panther Olympics, where every event hosted by our student government, classes can earn different points to raise their standings in the Panther Olympics, so we just kind of incorporated Toys for Tots with that.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know Guam High has a very large concentration of families that are in the military and, you know, like people that come from here and they're now Guamanians by virtue of the fact that they live here now. What does it mean, like, you know, for you as locals and everything, to have that kind of sense of, you know, community service and, you know, giving back to the community and, you know, really being socially responsible and everything for the place that you call home?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that having children who are growing in the military, I understand that people come and go, especially our friends. We've grown up together throughout our school life. So having people coming to the island and being able to give to them through the activities we hold at school, and especially this activity alone, is great for our school to blend with our community and island.
Mm-hmm. So of course the toys that you'll be gathering and everything like that will go to make a young child's Christmas and everything. So tell me, how has that been going and how have you been able to keep up the momentum?
Well, I think it's important that Toys for Tots is giving the toys back to kids on Guam, and I think that's what we're stressing the most at Guam High, just so that something that we can give back to the community, because the students at our school, some are locals and some do come and stay here for just a couple of years, so I think it's good that everyone's giving back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we would be remiss if we neglected to mention you've also brought a friend.
Oh, yes.
who has the best seat in the house?
Yes, he does. Actually looks kind of comfortable in there.
Yeah, okay. So how is the spirit of working with the Marines too, and, you know, like such a professional organization and people that are so dedicated and they've given their lives to service, you know, for our country and by association by the island? How have they been, you know, mentors to you, or, you know, like been able to work with you?
Well, definitely when they first came into our school, we were actually having a meeting with a lot of the classes, and they were explaining to us and really getting in depth with how it's not alone just for us to dedicate our time and spend time talking to the students to donate. It's more of just trying to get everybody involved and really giving to others rather than receiving.
So. Mm-hmm. How has the rest of the student body at Guam High, like, been responding to this? Because, of course, you know, you two are obviously in positions of leadership, and, you know, you're very motivated, as are the Marines. But how's everybody else in the school, and, like, how have you been able to, you know, kind of, like, share that love and that passion with others?
I think student government is doing a lot this month, especially just because it's the season of giving, and our student body has actually been really generous with every single organization that we have. Mm-hmm. Everyone's doing different things to give back.
Which isn't easy, because I remember what it was like to be in high school, even though that was, you know, decades ago for me. But, you know, you've got parties coming up, you've got, you know, exams, and you've got, you know, Christmas shopping and whatnot. So how do you both ladies manage that?
Well, actually, we do spend a lot of our time together.
Yeah.
A lot of our time is spent planning and definitely trying to figure out how to incorporate our activities with the school. So it's a lot of time planning and time management as well that...
Yeah.
We spend a lot of time
at the school. Over a week, we just spent Saturday at the school having meetings and stuff like that just to plan for the students. So, yeah.
Well, as we get closer and closer to when the toys will be distributed and everything like that, how do you guys plan to ramp up your activity and make sure that, you know, the Panther spirit is on full display?
Well, we actually have a morning broadcast that we kind of advertise for. Mm-hmm. And
We've actually the scores that we've brought into our competition are pretty high in relation to the games we have at pep rallies and stuff. So I think that's a big persuasive part of our.
I must say, when you said like broadcasting everything, just watching the way you two are like looking at each other and playing off each other, this is the easiest interview I've ever done. I'm just gonna sit back and let you guys like handle it and everything. Yeah. You guys are naturals.
Oh, thank you.
I love broadcasts.
We like talking. I think that's just we're the talkative ones in our meeting.
That is a big characteristic if you're gonna do great things in this business. Yeah. So you know, like we'll talk once you get out of college.
Okay, cool.
Very, very bright future for the both of you.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, so maybe for your classmates or anybody else like involved with the Panther family who isn't exactly like full-on dedicated yet, what words would you like to pass on to them as far as, you know, what you're doing with the Marines and with, you know, KUAM to make someone's Christmas a little bit brighter? You know, they may be going through hard times. Mm-hmm. How can you inspire them?
I think, no, just taking out the competition that we've instilled, I think it's important for them to know that because it's with the Marine Corps and all of us are associated with the military, and because it's for Guam and all of us obviously live here, it's really important to give back, especially during the season. And
it's a great way to bring us all together, pretty much, like mm-hmm. as a Panther family alone, but not only as a Panther family, but Guam all together. It's a great way to bring our schools together and students together.
And it really makes you appreciate what you guys have.
Oh, yes, very much.
All right. Well, thank you so much for what you're doing and for being involved with this. And you're outstanding examples of what it means to not only be a Guam High student, but what it means to be a true Guamanian.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
So we admire you both greatly.
Thank you.
All right. And please stay tuned, everybody, because we will be back when we continue after this.